इस वर्ष पूरा विश्व महात्मा गांधी की 150वीं जयंती मना रहा है। सत्य और अहिंसा का उनका संदेश विश्व की शांति, प्रगति और विकास के लिए आज भी प्रासंगिक है।
When a nuclear armed country fights to the end, it will have consequences far beyond the borders. It will have consequences for the world, which is why I repeat I'm here.
विकासशील देश दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा स्वच्छता अभियान सफलतापूर्वक संपन्न करता है। सिर्फ 5 साल में 11 करोड़ से ज्यादा शौचालय बनाकर अपने देशवासियों को देता है तो उसके साथ बनी व्यवस्थाएं पूरी दुनिया को एक प्रेरक संदेश देती है। जब एक विकासशील देश दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन कार्यक्रम सफलतापूर्वक चलाता है, सिर्फ 5 साल में 37 करोड़ से ज्यादा गरीबों के बैंक खाते खोलता है तो उसके साथ बनी व्यवस्थाएं पूरी दुनिया के गरीबों में एक विश्वास पैदा करती है। जब एक विकासशील देश अपने नागरिकों के लिए दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा डिजिटल आइडेंटिफिकेशन प्रोग्राम चलाता है, उनको बायोमेट्रिक पहचान देता है, उनका हक पक्का करता है, भ्रष्टाचार को रोककर करीब $20 बिलियन से ज्यादा बचाता है तो उसके साथ बनी आधुनिक व्यवस्थाएं पूरी दुनिया के लिए एक नई उम्मीद बनकर के आती है।
RSS was an organization that was inspired by Adolf Hitler and Mussolini, came about in 1925. This RSS believed in the ethnic cleansing of Muslims from India. That made Narendra Modi in 2002 do a pogrom against Muslims in Gujarat when he was the chief minister. He allowed 3 days for these RSS goons who were inspired by the Hitler brown shirts. They actually wear brown shirts. Mr. President, there will be another Palwama. Picks up a gun and he goes around shooting muggers. Does he think that people of Kashmir will quietly accept the status quo because India has changed the constitution and taken away the special status? They'll accept that. When the curfew is lifted, will be a bloodbath. The people will come out. There are 900,000 troops there. They haven't come to, as Narendra Modi says, he's done this too for the prosperity of Kashmir. This is supposed to be for the development. These 900,000 troops, what are they going to do when they come out? There'll be a bloodbath. The Congress Home Minister gave a statement that in RSS camps, terrorists are being trained. And these terrorists butchered 2,000 Muslims and 150,000 Muslims were made homeless. Narendra Modi could not travel to the US because of that. And what does Narendra Modi think? That 180 million Muslims of India are thinking right now. Aren't they watching these Kashmiris? I've heard about their rapes, Indian army going into homes, soldiers.
Mr. President, I take the floor to exercise India's right of reply to the statement made by the Prime Minister of Pakistan. Every word spoken from the podium of this August Assembly, it is believed, carries the weight of history. Unfortunately, what we heard today from Prime Minister Imran Khan of Pakistan was a callous portrayal of the world in binary terms. Us versus them, rich versus poor, north versus south, developed versus developing, Muslims versus others. Rarely has the General Assembly witnessed such misuse, rather abuse, of an opportunity to reflect. Words matter in diplomacy. The invocation of phrases such as pogrom, bloodbath, racial superiority, pick up the gun, and fight to the end reflect a medieval mindset and not a 21st century vision. Prime Minister Imran Khan's threat of unleashing nuclear devastation qualifies as brinksmanship, not statesmanship. Prime Minister Khan's justification of terrorism was brazen and incendiary. For someone who was once a cricketer and believed in the gentleman's game, today's speech bordered on crudeness of a variety reminiscent of the guns of Dara Adam Khel. Can Pakistan confirm the fact that it is home to 130 UN-designated terrorists and 25 terrorist entities listed by the UN as of today? Will Pakistan acknowledge that it is the only government in the world that provides pension to an individual listed by the UN in the Al-Qaeda and Daesh sanctions list? And finally, would Prime Minister Khan deny to the city of New York that he was an open defender of Osama bin Laden? Having mainstreamed terrorism and hate speech, Pakistan is trying to play its wild card as the newfound champion of human rights. This is a country that has shrunk the size of its minority community from 23% in 1947 to 3% today, and has subjected Christians, Sikhs, Ahmadiyyas, Hindus, Shias, Pashtuns, Sindhis, and Balochis to draconian blasphemy laws, systemic persecution, and blatant abuse and forced conversion. We would request you to refresh your rather sketchy understanding of history. Do not forget the gruesome genocide perpetrated by Pakistan against its own people in 1971 and the role played by Lieutenant General A.A.A. Mian. A sordid fact that the Honorable Prime Minister of Bangladesh reminded this assembly about earlier this afternoon.